I've already preloaded all three latest versions, and what I want to do is first open them up and see the differences between them and just really talking in the really, really small, minute things that we need to know where they are, and we're not going to dig too deep into them. So let's start with CS5 because it's the latest version. CS5, basically, as soon as you load it, you'll see that your CS5 has your welcome screen. That welcome screen is very similar to older versions of Flash, which I would love to toggle to in a minute. But what I want to do before we do that is I want to kind of talk over the most important elements that we're going to need to know how to find. One is our welcome screen, and if we can't find our welcome screen, we could always create a file new and create a new file, because we're mainly going to create new files or browse to open a recent file as you would do in most other applications if you wanted to open up a previously opened file. Now, as we said, we're working on an ActionScript 3 project, so when we want to create a new one, we'd select ActionScript 3 if we're creating a new file, and this would create a new FLA file that will be pre-configured and set up to work with ActionScript 3 codes. So you don't want to by mistake press an ActionScript 2, because then you're going to get different errors and different messages that would be confusing. Whenever we create AS files, which is our external ActionScript files, we would actually create an AS script file. So if I just toggle for a second to my Finder, let me just minimize this and go to the Finder. Let's see the connection between the two that I'm saying. So one is, if I'm going to reopen that and put this a bit in the side right here. So we said, so our new AS3 file is basically our FLA. Our AS, our main.as, and all the rest of the AS files are actually ActionScript files. And all it is just basic text that we're building in a certain way to make sure that Flash understands what it is. But basically, all it really is text, and we're going to see that momentarily. Okay, now, if your hello screen, your welcome screen, whatever you want to call this screen, doesn't pop open on your CS, and we've seen this now in CS5, let's just jump really quickly and see how would it look like in CS4. So let me just minimize my CS5. And let's maximize my CS4. And you'll see CS4 colors are different. There's a few things that are missing. It's not structured the same way, but here in the center, exact same thing. You got your AS3 file, which creates your FLA. You got your ActionScript file, which creates your AS file. And same deal. You could always create a new file. You could open. I don't have any recent, so we can't see any recent here. And let's see how it looks like in our CS3. So let me hide CS4. And let's CS3. And in CS3, same thing. The layout is completely different. Things are really not the same as they are in the newer versions. But we got our, in the screen, home screen, in our welcome screen, create a new file, an ActionScript 3 file, which is exactly the same thing as creating our new FLA, our main.fla. We could create by creating a new FLA file, a new AS3 project. Or we could create a new ActionScript file, which is what we've done in all the other samples. Okay, so, and the same deal here, we could have gone to file, new, we could open a recent file that we've worked on, and that's really, there's not much of a difference between the two. Now, if you couldn't find your hello screen, you must have set it up not to show again. It doesn't really matter. You could work from your file, new, or you could dig in your configurations and find how to return it, but it's really not critical. Okay, so let's toggle back into our CS5 and talk about other important panels. So we've seen our welcome panel and our save panel, which is obviously critical because we need to know how to open up files and how to save files. The next thing that's really important that we're going to dig deeper into in the next video is knowing how to find your properties panel. Now, the properties panel could be anywhere, and it really depends on your Flash version, but it also depends on your layout. You can see our layout right here is the basic layout, which is Essentials layout. Now, you could always at any time create your own layout or switch to that own layout. We're not going to dig too deep into it, but just by clicking on the Essentials layout will give you all the options that you currently have, your default options, or you could create new options after you set things up and configure it the way you want to configure it. You could get through it or through the clicking on your Essentials button or going through your Window, Workspaces, and selecting your workspace. Now let's just see the same thing we've just seen in CS5. Let's just repeat the same thing and see it in CS4. So if we're looking at CS4, we could see that same deal. We have our button. You see, I have a preset on that one, but we're working on Essentials, which is the default. You could create your own, save it if you're happy with a specific layout. And if you can't find it there, then you could go to your workspace and find the available workspaces you currently got. Let's see how this would look like in CS3. Let me just minimize the CS4 and CS5 because CS3 is kind of like a floater versus CS4 and 5, which are more closed applications. Anyway, let me stutter a bit. Okay, so in CS3, you see that one is you don't really have that button up there anymore. That's everything is kind of floating. And in your window, you don't really have. So if you don't have your welcome screen and you couldn't find things, the way you could find whatever we're talking about, let's start with CS3. Our main focus is actually finding the properties panel. That currently our properties panel is down here. Now, finding the properties panel, if it's not down here and you couldn't find it, you could always click on your... You see? But okay, right now, and this is good that we're bringing this up, that right now you see how it's dimmed? It's dimmed because it's not even a menu option right now. You can only get properties from something that's actually open. So if I'll just quickly create a new file just for the sake of this sample, you'll see that my properties panel now is enabled, and now we could start interacting with the properties panel. But if I click onto my window, if my computer wouldn't go crazy. Okay, so we're back. Thank God for that. Then we could toggle down again. Oh, I think Flash crashed. What version? Yeah, we're back to CS5. Ooh. I guess you shouldn't be running three versions of Flash at the same time. Interesting. Very cool. Okay. That kind of messed that up, that one up. But did it? I'm confused. Oh, actually, where are we? About Flash? We're still in CS3. Just the iconography is of CS5. Okay, that's what confused me. Okay, so we're back to talking about how do you find your properties panel. Sorry about that. So if you go to your window and just search for it, you'll find your properties. And you'll see that you got your little shortcut here as well if you need to use it. You can see that it's already set and it's V. That means on the stage. So it's time for it to look for it. And here we go. We found it. Okay, so that's CS3. Let me close down that file. Let me minimize CS3. And let's see how we do that in CS4. Looking at CS4, same deal. Probably we don't have access to the properties. We see that it's dimmed out. It's not going to be in the menu at all because we're not in a working file that we could start playing with its properties. So if we click on a new file, we'll see its properties. And same deal, we could find it in the window. So you can see that the menu differences are a little bit different, right? Now it's not collapsed. Now it's a main menu. It's the same shortcut though, but you could still see that it's selected. You could just search through the window, which the window panel just shows you all the different window-y type of panels that you could actually open or close, and there's quite a lot of them. So just find it, and you're good. And let's see how that works in CS5, which should be basically the same thing, but let's do it anyways. Doesn't hurt to practice. So one, we could see our properties panel is already open up, but it's disabled. So what we could do is, again, we create a new AS3 file. Now it's not disabled, but if we couldn't find it, we could always go to our window, search for our properties, click it to bring it in, or in our scenario, get rid of it because it was already there, click on it again to bring it back in. Okay, so that was our properties panel. The next panel that's really critical to know about is our file publish settings. And we're going to dig deeper into it in the next videos. And it's the same file publish settings both in CS5 and CS4. We obviously have to create a file, publish settings, and even in CS3, create a new file, and then file publish settings. But I guess things are running a bit slower on CS3. So we might abandon showing it on CS3 every time. Okay, so but that's really just the heart of it. So here we go. And we could go to our publish settings also on CS3. They're very, very similar. Now there's obviously small little differences, and that's where you kind of need to get used to it. But we're not going to go over them and over them. We're just going to show you those differences once in this intro course, and then we're going to assume that you already know how to find it.